This tutorial will illustrate some of the capabilities that CSiBridge offers for performing load rating. For this simple example, we wish to determine the operating rating factor for flexure for a P5 truck load. The single span bridge we will rate is constructed of curved steel girders with braced diaphragms, supporting a concrete deck. The girders are W33s by 118s, and the deck is 8 inches thick, and we will assume a 3.5 inch thick wear surface. The bridge spans 60 feet and is 27 feet wide with two lanes of traffic. For the live load distribution factor determination, we will use method 3, where the distribution is based on the analysis. When using this method, the model must be updated as an area object model. We will use a single lane for the live load case, and we will position the lane to the inside of the curve. The formula used for determining a load rating may be stated simply as capacity minus dead load divided by live load plus impact. CSiBridge uses the following equation for determining the rating factor in flexure for steel girder bridges, where Rn is the nominal moment capacity calculated by the program, gamma dc is the factored moment demand due to the dead load of the bridge, gamma dw is the factored moment demand due to the dead load of the wearing surface, and gamma ll is the factored moment demand due to the live load. We start by going to the Components tab, and in the Superstructure panel, we will modify the bridge section. Here, we will switch the girders modeling object type to Mixed, which uses shell elements for the web and frame elements for the flange. Next, we will review our load patterns on the Loads tab. Dead has already been defined, but we need to add a load pattern for the wearing surface. Next, we will define our vehicle. For this rating, we will use a P5. Note that no dynamic allowance is included with this load, as the speed of this truck would typically be restricted. However, we are going to add in a dynamic allowance factor of 0.33 when we define our vehicle class using the P5 truck. While we are still on the Loads tab, we will define an area load for the wearing surface. Assuming it is 3.5 inches thick with a weight of 150 pounds per cubic foot, we input a load value of 0.0438 at both edges. Moving to the Bridge tab, we can add the wear surface load just defined to the bridge object using the Loads icon. Next, we move on to the Analysis tab, where we will set the analysis cases. We start with the dead case. The dead case is predefined, but it is a linear elastic case, and we are going to modify it such that it will use staged construction to give non-composite behavior. However, before we can do this, we need to define a few other items. Selecting all of the deck, we will assign these objects to a group called deck. While on the Advanced tab, we will select the name property set for area modifiers. And add a set for wet concrete. Here, we reduce the axial and moment capacities of the deck so that it will not carry load. We define a second name property set with all of the factors set to 1 when the concrete is ready to act compositely. Now we will return to the Analysis tab. We will modify the dead load case to be nonlinear stage construction. And we will define 2 stages. In the first stage, we will add all of the structure and then apply the section modifiers for the wet concrete to the deck. And then add the dead load. This should result in all the dead load being carried by the girders in a non-composite manner. In stage 2, we will revise the deck modifiers so that they will act in a composite manner for additional loads that may be applied. In addition to the dead and wearing surface cases, we will define a case for the live load. We will use our vehicle class 1 that contains our P5 vehicle, and we'll load lane 2. Note that we have only one lane loaded. Now we are ready to run the analysis for our 3 load cases, dead or DC, wearing surface or DW, and live load. With the analysis complete, we will now set our combinations to be used for determining the operating load rating for flexure. Switching to the Design Rating tab, we will start by defining a dead combo. Here, we will call it dead gamma to indicate that it includes the gamma factor. And we will use a factor of 1.25 for an operating rating. Our dead load combo for the wear surface will be called wearing surface gamma. And we'll also use a factor of 1.25. The last combo defined will be for the live load. And here we will use a factor of 1.35. Remember that a dynamic load allowance was accounted for in the vehicle class definition. With our three combinations defined, we move on to the load rating panel. Clicking the preferences, we will use the ASHTO LRFD 2007 code. Next, we move on to the rating request. We will call this rating request flexure rating. We will set the rating type to composite strength. This denotes that the rating will be based on full composite action of the bridge. Next, we specify the demand set combos. Dead gamma for DC. Wearing surface gamma for DW. And live load gamma for the live load plus IM combo. Clicking on the Modify Show button for the rating parameters, we will leave the fee factors set to 1. The only change we will make is to set Use Stage Analysis to Yes and Short Construction to No. Under the live load distribution area, we will set the method to method 3, where the distribution of live load is based on the analysis. We can now run the rating for our flexure rating request. When the analysis is complete, the bridge object response form is displayed. Shown is the plot for flexure rating factors along the span for the girder farthest away from the lane. Note that the minimum value is approximately 6.9. We can also view the factors for the other girders, including the right girder. For this girder, the load rating drops to 2.2. We can also show all the girders together. Note that each girder has different load rating factors. This information is also available in tabular form. And if we select the composite strength table, not only are dead, wearing surface, and live load moments displayed, but all of the intermediate values used in the capacity calculations are shown as well. This table can also be exported to Excel for further review. This concludes this tutorial on load rating.